simply perfect. It had to be done. I don't know, go back and do it again. Do you want one more?
Hello!
A top 10, a perfect 10, 10 out of 10. What marks are you giving your Olympic Games experience as we welcome day 10 at Tokyo 2020? Let's take a look at today's lineup. Fearless and fun, teenage skateboarding sensation Skye Brown bubbles with delight ahead of her Olympic debut. Sports climbing is prepared for liftoff too, but don't blink or you'll miss it. And Harry Sugiyama bows down at the Temple of the Cat.
Hello!
With thousands of Olympians having competed and completed their sports events, they're returning home to loved ones near and far. Take a look at just a few of the open arm welcomes from around the world. Lovely, and we all need a hug from time to time, don't we? Now, one of the highlights of week one here in Japan was the teenage dominance on the women's street skateboarding podium, and they ain't done yet. The park event will soon see Skye Brown skate the bowl, and less than a month after her 13th birthday, she cannot wait to drop in as an Olympian.
Hello! Yeah, I mean, I'm so proud of everyone. I mean, she killed it. It was so cool. And I loved how she was, you know, dancing in there, smiling. And also Momiji, she was insane. She's also a really good friend of mine. And she's 13 as well. And it was really cool. It was really cool to see the younger ones, you know, do really good. And it was fun. It was fun watching Leticia as well. Everyone is ripping and everyone, you know, was just having fun skating with friends. And yeah, it was really cool. I don't feel any pressure. I don't really feel nervous. Like, you know, skateboarding is fun, and I mean, all my friends are going to be there with me, so I feel pretty good.
I love that you have such an energetic and positive mindset. Do you think that the nerves will come a little bit later on, or do you feel confident that you will just feel quite relaxed the entire time?
No, I think I won't. I mean, I'm definitely going to try my best for the UK and try to get a medal. That would be insane. Like, that would be a dream come true. I'm going to try my best, but I'm just going to enjoy the time. Try not to feel, you know, just going to be like skating with my friends, you know. But I do know the whole world is watching me, but I think it's going to be awesome. I don't think, you know, people know how beautiful skateboarding is, so being in the Olympics could really change skateboarding. And
well, that smile is worth a medal alone. Time to unwind now with our daily dip into a fascinating art called origami. Now, artistic gymnastics combines dexterity with speed, which is something you also need to be an Olympic sport climber. Combining bouldering with lead and speed ascents up humongous walls is really fascinating viewing.
sports climbing will benefit the Olympics. I hope so, because it's a young and dynamic sport. We bring assets like community aspect, fun aspect to the Olympics.
There's really nothing like climbing, so I think it'll bring a lot of new ideas.
Sport climbing will change the Olympics by introducing the new fastest sport. So speed climbing will be over in 5.5 seconds. I'm hoping that the other disciplines of climbing will show people the appeal of having a sport that's different every time, and how cool it can be to watch an athlete get creative and try to problem solve, and how that can affect their placement in the competition.
I'm convinced that also the Olympics will benefit climbing.
Climbing in Olympics, for sure, it's crazy for our sports. All people can see our beautiful sports, because climbing it's very beautiful.
People are going to learn about it, which is really cool, because in South Africa not that many people know about climbing. There's still a lot of people, you'll say, oh, I'm a climber, and they're like, climbing?
やっぱりクライミングの楽しさをオリンピックを通してやっぱりいろんな人に知ってもらえるっていう、そういう機会を得れたっていうのはすごく嬉しく思いますし、あとはやっぱりクライミングはきっと皆さんに知ってもらったら、みんな楽しい、このスポーツはこんなに楽しいんだって分かってもらえるスポーツだと思うので、そうですね、なんかまだまだこう希望のある、いろんな意味ですごく可能性のあるスポーツだと思います。
Cat-like skills if ever I saw them. And you know what? Tokyo is no stranger to our four-legged feline friends, as TV's Harry Sugiyama is about to discover.
Hello everyone! Cats! Cats! Cats!
It's a heaven full of cats!
Cats that are going to bring you good luck and great fortune.
Hello you.
So I've got hold of my maneki neko, the beckoning cat. What do? I make my wish and take it back home. And once that wish is granted, I bring it back to Gotokuji.
As you can see, there are thousands of maneki neko cats right here. From big to small, you've got the locals, the Japanese and tourists. They put new maneki neko cats here every single day. So the number of cats just keeps getting larger and larger and larger.
So how did you find coming to Gotokuji, the so-called birthplace of the famous maneki neko, the cat that brings you good luck?
Thanks, Harry. That was simply perfect. Had to be done. Today is day 10, and that means medals in men's singles badminton.
Wide, Chen Long becomes the Olympic champion.
That's all we have time for, but Olympics.com is your go-to for our live vlog of every moment of action at Tokyo 2020. Not only that, but you can check schedules, results, and analysis to prepare you for what's ahead on day 11, which is where we'll meet again. Ciao for now.